Yo, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to a brand new video. Today we have my most wanted top 20 retired Lego set. So this is actually a collab video with Lego Boy, and thanks for joining me, Lego Boy, on this collab video. And I just want to say some honorable mentions. There are actually two. We have the Skull Truck and the Hoth Wampa Cave. So these two are my honorable mentions. I really like this set, but they didn't really fit in the list. So at number 10 we have the Lego House. This is a display set, more like a playable set, because it's an architecture Lego set and it's very colorful. I really like colorful stuff, and it can actually open up, and that's a very cool like play feature. You have, I believe, a printed tile that says Lego House. I believe it's like a 1x8 and it's very big, and I think it's very cool. So at number 9 we have the UCS Assault on Hoth. Now a lot of people hate this set. I'm not gonna say dislike it, hate it, because of its inaccuracies and all that stuff. Now I know that shield generator is like has 3 shield things, not 4, and the Hoth Wampa Cave can fit through this thing. His like cave can fit through the front door, and it's called Assault on Hoth, and there's really not assault. But I really like the set. Like, it has the bubble to it. It has like a little area to stand the troopers. You can like change a lot of stuff into it. I'm not gonna talk about it a lot because you're probably gonna click off this video. So at number 8 we have the Temple of Light. This is a 2013 set, and I really like the golden mech. Like, it's very cool. Get a like possessed Garmadon, just like a regular Garmadon, but it has like the mask helmet thing. You can see the white and gold on the mech, and just really cool. You can close the temple up and put the mech in it, and you can like open it up, as you can see. Get two regular like one scout trooper and one stone like warrior, stone scout warrior, I don't know what they call them. And you get the golden ninja, woo, and the Garmadon, possessed Garmadon. You get the four blade, and I really like that. Get like woo's grandfather and father and grandfather and the back. I believe that's a sticker. Got like a fire in the center, and it's just a really cool set. So at number 7 we have Epic Dragon Battle. Now we get the Ultra Dragon, and I think it's a very cool like a dragon. Get like 3-4 heads on a dragon. I almost said 3, sorry. Like, you don't see that like on any set. You get like the yellow head for Jay, for lighting, the special molded head that has like brown on it, it's for Cole, and the other two are for Kai and Zane. Get two Jay, get two generals, Serpentine generals, and I really like that. You get Garmadon with the 4 golden weapons, get Lloyd, you get Chokon, and get a little prison for like the secret thing, secret temple or something. I forgot what the name is. You can put a little minifigure inside the mouth of the devourer, and the devourer just really cool. Like, he's just like really cool. Now it doesn't capture him perfectly, but it's very cool. So at number 6 we have Palpatine Arrest. Now this is a very cool set. Like, I can't say bad stuff about it. Get the Jedi, like the starfighters that Anakin come out of it. It's a very cool design. You can see Anakin coming out of it, and you can see here's like the windows of Palpatine's office, or whatever you want to call it. And you can see like besides Palpatine chair, and you have like his little lightsaber with the golden hilt and a little crystal. Like, this crystal doesn't make sense to be in it, but I guess the Lego added like just an extra detail. And you get two little like chairs slash couches, and it's very detailed, and it was a Target exclusive back in the day, and I really dislike that. So at number 5, I think you're gonna be surprised with this one. You get Yoda's Hut. Now, probably this period of time I really want this set because I saw it on a toy store shelf like the other day. You can check out my vlog, it's gonna come out like in a month or something. Because like it was $250 and its retail price is $30, and I don't know why is that, and I really dislike that. And there's a lot of features in it. You can see Luke meditating, you can see the interior with a little bed and some food stuff and other stuff, and you get a lot of play features. You can see here the back of the box, so some play features. And it's just a very cool set. Like Yoda is very cool, R2-D2 is an exclusive minifigure, and Luke is an exclusive minifigure, and I really like this set. Like, it's one of the better hot sets. So at number 4 we have the Fire Temple with the Kai Dragon. It's just called the Fire Temple, and I think Lego Boy did like want this, but I just put it on here because you get like the Fire Dragon is very cool, and you can open the Temple of Light and stuff, and you can close it with the Fire Dragon in it. And it's just a very cool set. Not gonna talk a bunch into it, but it's just a very cool set. So at number 3 we have the Betrayal at the Cloud City set. So I really love this set. Like, it's the only Master Builder set. I don't know if the upcoming Mos Eisley Cantina is a Master Builder. Well, I hope it's Master Builder, but I really don't know. You can see the little balcony when they have the epic duel. You can see a little like corridor with a little building in it, and where Lando lead them into Vader. You can see the dining room right now. It has details into it. And you can see the freezing chamber, the carbon freezing chamber, and you can see this like overall view of it, and it just has a lot of it. Like, it just had a lot into it. You can see you have a little slave one. I'm gonna stop there, sorry. And you have the twin pod cloud core, and I really like that. Like, it's just a very cool set. So at number 2 we have Dragon's Forge. Now, I used to see this set on shelves and really wanting it. Now, it's just a very cool set. You get the blacksmith shop and the dragon, what was it called? I really don't remember the dragon's name. And it's a very good display, like cool display piece for your shelf when the blacksmith is closed. And with this open, it's actually very cool. It has a couple of play features. As you can see, it has a lot of weapons. It has some little like sushi stuff, and you get like this little mech and 2 vermilion warriors, and it's just like a very cool model. So at number 1 we have Samurai X Cave Chaos. This one is same thing as the previous one. I always saw it on shelves and really wanted it. Now, it has a lot of hidden play features and like regular play features. Get a lot of like screen panels. You can move actually the floor to like see the hidden play features. Here you can see like an overall look of it. And you can get a little like robot and a little prison with the lasers. You get a little bike to jet ride, and you get a little jet thing or airplane or whatever you want to call it for Nia. And you get a little mech, and actually these like 3 vehicles, you can like customize them and stuff. So that's going to be for today's video. There's still Ryan's thing, so switch out to Ryan.
So what is going on, everybody? So this is my top 10 retired sets after Alex did his. So at number 1, these are in no particular order, we have the 2013 Republic gunship. It's the best gunship to date in my opinion. Number 2, we have the Lego Ninjago 2015 Temple of Erijutsu. One of the best Ninjago large sets ever in my opinion. Number 3, we have the Monster Fighters Vampire Castle from 2012. Very similar to the Hidden Side Castle this year, but better. Number 4, we have the LEGO Ideas Ghostbusters Ecto-1. I missed out on this, but I really wish I didn't because Ghostbusters was incredible. At number 5, we have the Clone Walker Battle Pack, the best battle pack ever. Number 6... We have the Republic Venator. I have this set, but I still think it's like so good. Number 7 is another Star Wars set, the best UCS set ever, the Slave One. I really wish I got this set. It's just so good. Number 8, we got the Fire Temple from 2011, the first wave in Jango. This set is just incredible. Number 9, we have the Scooby-Doo Mystery Machine. It is one of the most iconic vehicles ever, in my opinion. And finally, at number 10, we have the 2014 ATTE. Just a great ATTE walker.
So that's going to be for today's video. Thank you, Ryan, for joining me on this collab. And as I said, it's been Alex, Ryan, and we are out. If you enjoyed, smash that like button and subscribe to be a part of the A-Gang. Or consider subscribe. I don't know why I say subscribe to be a part of the A-Gang. But consider subscribing and subscribe to Lego Boy. He's just hit like 100 subscribers. And that's really cool. So that's it. Bye, peace. If you want to check out other like top 10 lists and other stuff or list to best, be sure to click on the playlist on the edge screen right now. Peace.
Help me help you. Girl, what you trying to do? Cause I don't got a clue. No, I ain't no Scooby-Doo.
Help you.
Cause I'm hungrier than you. I just wanna get some food and you about to kill
help
my mood.
Help you.